Hello everyone. In this video, I will go over some of the new updates for CLO3D. This is for version 7.0. So we'll start with the integration of Pantone chips into the color palette. So I have my file here. I have the object browser open. I have the property editor open, and I have selected my base fabric, silk organza. Now that I have the property editor open, you will see here the color that you're currently using. Or if you don't have a color, this would say none. So I'm gonna left click on the chip in order to open the color pop-up window. So here you can see that the Pantone brand name is prominently displayed. And the only issue here is that when you go to the bottom right here and hover over the information, you will actually see a pop-up window that says Pantone color displayed herein may not match Pantone identified standards. Consult current Pantone color publications for accurate color. So that's a little disappointing at the least. Why wouldn't these match the colors of Pantone or the official colors? But I guess this maybe depends on the kind of screen that you have, maybe on the settings that you have on your screen. So I would hope that that's what this means. And I presume that the most accurate way to view real colors, so the actual colors, is if you have the printed color chips by Pantone. Obviously, this is protected by trademark by the Pantone company. So let's take a look at what we have here in the Pantone section of this color palette. So up here, you can see that currently I have three different tabs open. And if I left click on the first one, that shows me my nylon brights. Click on the second one, I have cotton, and the third one represents the polyester. If for some reason these are closed, you closed them or they were never open, you can come here to the very first one that says Pantone colors and left click right here on the drop down menu, and you will see the three options for polyester, cotton, and nylon brights. Obviously, these are completely different fabrics and they will represent different colors, or they will dye different. If you actually had the real fabric in front of you, you may see that exact color might be a lot brighter or shinier. It really depends on the fabric. As I'm clicking on the different color palettes, these are the current chips that I have represented right now. So let's take a look at the bottom right here. And here we can choose between a list view or detail view. So if I left click once here, we will see a list view for every single palette that you can browse through. And if you click back on it, you will get the detailed view. You can click one more time and that will give you the actual color chips and just color chips without the names. What I find useful here is that you can see the Pantone color number. And knowing the number, if you happen to have the catalog or the Pantone chips with the colors, instead of visually looking for the color that you want, you could also come down here on the bottom left and type a very particular color. And you can find your color that way. Let me come out of it. So for example, here I can type, let's say 18, I think that's a real color. And if it isn't, then that will not show me a color, but let's say you know your color. So let's find a 13-21-20, for example. 13-21-20, and see if we'll find me that chip. So yes, so this is a real Pantone number, and it located what this color is. It's showing me that it is cotton candy color. And I can see it here in the nylon brights, or up here I see the default color. Now, what this new color palette also does, a new feature that we have here, is that once we have the color that we want, you can also come here to this little icon at the bottom left and left click on that, and it should give you all of the similar colors that are part of that family of hues. So it didn't really do that. Let's try it again. So I'm going to select, let's say, this color, and I will go for similar colors. Cheeky pink. Let's try this again. So this seems to be glitching right now. It is actually not working, and I'm not sure if this is a glitch or let's go to the basic color palette here, and I'm going to select this yellow color or any yellow color, and I want to come here and left click, and now it is actually giving me a couple of similar colors. So I'm not sure why this doesn't work all the time, every time. Is there particular settings? So it is selecting the color. So very curious here how this actually works. Okay, so we have our full color palette here. I'm going to select a, let's say this orange color, and I would like to see similar colors. I'm going to left click here. And yes, it gives me similar color that have a very similar hue. So I could select something that is right around that particular hue. So this seems as if we need to go to the primary color palette and then go from there. Let's try it again with a different color. I'm going to go for this green. So I'm going to clean out what we had here. So I'm going to go for this green color and see if it will give me similar hues. Left click right here, and it does not. So it probably doesn't recognize or doesn't have a specific Pantone color for this. So let's go with the Pantone colors in the official color palette. So I'm going to go for a green that is here. It exists in this color palette. I'm going to select that. And now I'm going to go for find me similar colors. It did not find me similar colors. It just gave me that particular color. So let's clear that selection, try something else. I know that there are some various red here. I'm going to select one of these and then go for the similar colors. Left click once, and now it did give me similar colors. So my presumption here is that it is selecting only similar colors if they exist in the Pantone chip color family. So that's what I presume that this means. So I'm going to clear this selection and show you one more feature. Right here at the bottom, we still have this slider that makes the color chips bigger or smaller, and we can see larger portion of them. Let's see how that works in the grid view. So this helps a lot when you actually want to locate what is the number and the name of a particular color, and you can see more information. What I don't like is that it really scales out and the name disappears out of the window, but you do see it larger. So I guess that is really the limitation of how this can be scaled in this particular window. So let's see one more. So when I clicked on the grid view where we have even more lists of Pantone colors, then working with this zoom in and out makes it even harder to see. And it's really cutting off the numbers here, so we can't even see that. So that's actually not very well functioning. And I don't even see a way to maybe grab and move these or somehow slide so I can see individual color. So even when I select an individual color, I don't really see the Pantone color numbers appearing. I have no reference for what this is. So I'm not very happy with this feature. So I would keep sliding. I would say stay with the single list view. That is much more helpful. So these are some of the new features here for the Pantone colors. And the only other thing here is adding colors, building your own color palette here, and then exporting that color. For that, you can also take a look at my other video on the CLO3D 7.0 update. Thank you for watching. And I appreciate your time, and feel free to ask any questions or leave me any comments with anything that I might have missed here or any other questions that you might have.